go ahead and bring up the slides. We have a really great presentation for you on branding. I know that we have heard from a lot of our speakers here, not speakers, but our VPPRs, how you really wanted to learn a lot about branding. So we really wanted to bring people here who understood, who are very passionate about branding. So I'm just want to cut off a couple things, because sometimes with Zoom, it starts to take over, especially when you're trying to share your presentation. Okay, here we go. So I just want to welcome everyone for coming today. It's all about branding. We are all professionals, and we all see a lot of logos and a lot of brands out there. And then being in Toastmasters, we definitely wanted to understand, how can we brand our clubs? And you know, you have to start, you have to learn, you have to apply action, and you got to have results. And that's the reason why you are here. And the three speakers we have today, we have Carrie Lannon, we have VPPR Mandy, and we have Dr. AlyceAnn Crump. And they all come with their unique branding tips. And it's just gonna be something that you're going to take back to your club. And even if you don't belong to a Toastmaster, this is something that you probably can use for your personal development and your career, and then also your business as well. The person that I'm bringing up first, she is no stranger to PR. This is something that she does for her profession. She is a CEO and founder of Lannon Consulting, and she's worked with a lot of brand names like Tiffany, and that you see downtown, and Ulta Beauty. And she will get into a lot of the concepts about branding and how you can also apply this to your Toastmasters, especially for those who are VPPRs. Before I start, I am going to share the controls with, okay, hold on for a moment, with Carrie, because she's going to be presenting to you. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that.
We practiced this last night, everyone.
We did.
I can control my slide. Yes. I don't want Valerie controlling my slides.
Right. Here's the remote control. And then I'm going to give that to you, Mandy, right now. Let me know if you have it.
I think I do. Let's see if it works. You can control Valerie's screen. Excellent. Do I need to click something? It doesn't, it says I can control it. Doesn't say okay.
Yeah, sometimes you have to click on
this. Did I do that?
You have to click on this screen. I got it. Sometimes.
Okay. Hi, everyone. I'm really, really excited.
Okay, let me get that. Yeah. If you can mute yourself.
Valerie, you can mute everybody.
Yes, I can do that for you.
I think my...
Okay. Oh, wait a minute. We don't want to mute you. So you have to unmute yourself.
The slide moved on its own. Can you take, Okay. I don't know if this is going to work. There we go. Okay. Hi, everyone. Oh, don't you love Zoom? Just love it. Okay. I am, what Valerie also didn't mention is I am a Toastmaster. So I was with Speak Freaks, which is District 103. And I'm currently with Windy City Professional Speakers, which is District 30. Professionally, I do branding and communications. I have a major corporate background, working with some pretty snazzy brands like Tiffany & Company, Mercedes-Benz, et cetera. And now I work with entrepreneurs, so with their businesses, and I also do personal branding. And it's just such a pleasure for me to share what I've learned over the years about branding. I'm very enthusiastic about branding. So I'm going to attempt to change a slide now. Here we go. Okay, Valerie, why don't you just take the screen over because I don't think this is working. There we go. Next slide. There we go. So the reason that branding is so important these days is because we're in what I call the age of instant transparency. And if you think about, and most of you probably aren't old enough to know this, but you can imagine, you know, in the old days, you'd have a resume, and the only person that saw the resume was the person who you showed the resume to. Now, your resume's on LinkedIn, you've got probably social channels, so we can get to know someone pretty quickly, and I'm sure all of you have done the Google search when you're about to meet someone new. So this is why branding has become more important than it's ever been. And I want to explain how brands are created. I'll also make some references to Toastmasters so you understand how these concepts relate to your own clubs. Next. So what is branding? And I wrote it right here. Branding is creating an image for a business, service, or product in the consumer's mind. And hold on a minute. Branding aims to establish differentiated presence in the market to attract and retain loyal customers. Each of you has a Toastmasters club, and each of those clubs most likely has some kind of brand distinction or personality. And I know this is true because Toastmasters encourages people to attend different club meetings so that they can find the one that really suits them. So that word differentiated is a very important part of branding. Next. Along with the brand, an important part of branding is the brand promise. And a brand is a promise and an expectation. So think about, you know, maybe a local store that you like, they're a brand, any kind of brand that you do work with or are a consumer with. And think if suddenly they did something that was off brand, like the product wasn't good, or they wouldn't take your return, then they are going against their brand promise because most likely you have a certain expectation of that brand. And just like people coming to our clubs, they have an expectation of what they're going to expect to experience at the club. So when you hear the term brand promise, that's what brand promise means. Next. So this is the Toastmasters brand promise. It's where leaders are made. Toastmasters is saying, we are going to work with you to become leaders if that's a direction you want to take. And they're very clear about that. Pathways program is about building leadership skills and helping you be a leader, whether you're just speaking to your colleagues at work or speaking to large audiences. Next. Brand distinctions are a really important part of branding. And here I have two slides of two different airline companies. The one on the left, at least my left, is American Airlines. And the one on the right is Southwest Airlines. Now you can already see just from these images that these two brands take a different approach to how they interact with customers, how they interact with each other. On the right, everyone's lined up. It looks very corporate, doesn't it? It's very, a little more rigid. As opposed to Southwest Airlines, which is one of my favorite brands because they're always so on brand and they have a strong brand personality. Everyone's together. It's a little more tongue in cheek. So that says a lot about different kinds of brand distinctions. Next. So people have brands too, and I actually work with people to develop their brands. And that never means we're working to make them something that they're not. It means that we're bringing their attributes that they want to be known for to the front so that people can get to know them better, faster, see if it's a match for them. And here's some public people that each have brands. And if you wonder, you know, do they have a brand? I mean, you know, Denzel's just Denzel. But if Denzel or Tom Hanks ever said anything off brand, like say if Denzel said something that Kanye West would say, you'd probably be pretty surprised because you have a certain expectation of what his brand he stands for, as you do with Jessica Alba and Tom Hanks and First Lady Michelle Obama. So when you hear about this personal branding, it's about aligning. You'll hear the word aligning a lot, the attributes of the person with their brand. Next. Next. Okay. So when I'm working with clients and people, just to let you know where brands start, they start with a lot of what we call attributes, a lot of words. And this could be a really fun exercise to do within your clubs to figure out what are the words that really stand for your club. There's a word in here, fun loving. Some clubs might be fun loving. Some might be more serious, right? More intellectual. And so when I'm working, whether I'm working with a company or person, believe it or not, I start with this, with everyone going through a brand attribute exercise where they pick out the 10 top words and then we narrow those down. This can take, you know, hours. It's not an instant answer, but it's also very thought provoking. And it helps whether I've worked with groups or person, it helps people come together and say, yeah, what do we stand for? And in your case, what does our club stand for? What is its personality? Next. So the Toastmasters brand is attributes, is empowering individuals through personal and professional development. So this is a bit, this is taking all the attributes of the Toastmasters brand and putting it into a sentence that's very succinct. And the hardest part about branding is we always are coming up with very short descriptions that say a lot. Think about like Nike, just do it. You know, some of those taglines are telling a lot in a very few words. So with Toastmasters, it's empowering individuals through personal and professional development. Next. Another part of coming up with a brand is to look at its brand values. And Toastmasters has some very clear brand values. They actually have an excellent brand manual, which is where I took this information from. And their core brand values are integrity, respect, service, and excellence. And when I work with companies especially, it's very important that they understand what their brand values are, because that is what helps their team members, helps them understand what is driving the work. You know, if it's service, that's going to be top of mind with all of the team members. So core brand values, if you go to any big company, they all have, they know what their brand stands for. They know what their mission is. They know what their core brand values are. So if you walk away with something tonight, I want you to understand that putting together a brand is a very thoughtful process, obviously, that just doesn't happen. It takes a lot of thought, and it takes looking at other competitive brands and saying, well, they're doing that. How do we stand out? Next. So it's nice to have a brand, but if it's just sitting there, it's not doing anything for you. And I'd like to talk to you about how do you activate a brand? After we know what our core values are and our attributes, what do we do with this brand to help people hear about it, learn about it, and identify it? And there's four ways to activate a brand. Next. Four channels are your visual identity, your communications, user experience, and team empowerment. So this is for business branding, your visual identity, communications, user experience, and team empowerment. And I'll go through each of these four to explain what I mean by these and give you some examples. Next slide. So visual identity, if I were talking in front of you in person and I said, what's visual identity for a brand? I'm sure that most of the answers I would get would be a logo. And you'd be mostly correct. A logo is really important. But along with the logo, next slide, comes things like the colors and does the logo have a picture or not? You can get so much just from looking at a logo. And I work with designers that only work on logos. And I always think there's some kind of magic when they can take my brand summary that explains, you know, what the brand stands for, what their values are, and then they create a visual identity for that brand. So you can see right away that Trader Joe's is kind of a, you know, more of a down-home friendly logo. Intercontinental is quite chic. The brand is, the logo is a visual representation of the brand. And next slide, please. Those logos often change as the brand changes. This is Motorola, and you can see to the left where they started in 1947, and then kind of the turquoise logo, very clean and modern on the far right. And that just shows you that, of course, brands change just a bit. They have to stay up with the times. And so you will sometimes see the logo changing as well. Next. But a brand, a visual identity is more than just a logo. It's all these things you see here where everything lines up. I'll use Trader Joe's. You go there, you see the logo, their bags look a certain way, the uniforms look a certain way, the merchandising is done in a certain way. All of that is part of visual identity. When you're in a Toastmasters club, you obviously have some limitations because Toastmasters is very strict about how their logo is used and whether or not you can have a logo for your club. But I wanted you to understand that visual identity is an important part of how a brand is represented. Next slide. Well, next we talk about communications, and that's all kinds of ways that you communicate. And in big companies, it's even how you communicate with each other. So communications should also be very much on brand. And one of the distinguishing characteristics of communications is tone of voice. Next slide. Tone of voice determines the language. That means like what words are you using, the approach, and the sentiment. So here's some examples of tone of voice. It can be funny. It could be serious. It could be irreverent. I have two kind of signs here for a cafe. One says, please ask us for our brunch menu, very friendly and nice. And the other one says, damn fine coffee. You're going to get a different impression from each of those because it's a different tone of voice. And I'll give you, for example, when I talked about American Airlines versus Southwest, Southwest is a very friendly tongue-in-cheek tone of voice that you'll see even on the airplanes, the flight attendants will say funny things and do funny things. And if you remember a few years ago when United Airlines had a problem and they had a big PR problem, because they dragged a man off the plane. It was very bad and it made the news and the video went viral. And so Southwest had a response to that, and I'll show you what their response was on the next slide. We beat the competition, not you. And what I thought was so smart about this is it's funny. It's not really making fun or directly, you know, naming United Airlines, but it's very much in keeping in character with their brand, that it's something tongue in cheek and humorous and entertaining. Now, next slide. What some people forget is that, these are the tone of voice for Toastmasters brand, and they have this in the brand manual. They want people to communicate warm, clear, friendly, professional, succinct, respectful, universally understandable, internationally friendly. And of course, that's because Toastmasters is an international brand. And that is why I've worked with international companies. They are usually very strict about how their logo is used, what their tone of voice is, because they're trying to be consistent and aligned across an international audience. So it's very important that they remain consistent. And I know when I worked with Tiffany and Company, they had a whole department that would just actually kind of track down, you know, when someone was misusing the Tiffany logo or the Tiffany colors. It's very important for an international brand to stay on brand. Some platforms that people sometimes forget also relay tone of voice and communications is in the next slide. And that is your digital presence and of course your social media channels. Sometimes it doesn't happen now because most brands are pretty savvy, but in thinking about your club, if you have a Facebook page, is it representing the personality, the brand of your club consistently? Or is it a disconnect? It's something that's very different from what you feel your club stands for. And so let's keep in mind digital presence, especially social media channels, because they're very important. When I work with personal branding, we always, you know, do a digital audit. We look at what's being said about the person, what is their LinkedIn saying, and line those up. Most cases they are not, because people don't have this awareness of making sure that everything is consistent. Next slide. User experience. And you hear this word a lot in regards to technology. You know, what is the user experience if you're using your iPhone or your computer? But user experience also can relate to how club members are experiencing you, or in retail, it's a very important part of how customers are serviced. Next slide. And so user experience includes all customer contact. I was the head of PR for Ulta Beauty. We had 800 stores at the time I was there. So customer contact there included the service line when people called to complain. It included the people in the stores and how they serviced the clients. It included how we were treating each other. It's very important that all customer and even associate contact is a positive one, a simple one. It's a very important part. Next slide. When user experience is inconsistent, it weakens the brand. It confuses people. You might have a brand that says, or let's say there's a club and they're touting how professional they are and they're going to help you with leadership skills. And then you show up for the first time and everything is disorganized. That's an inconsistent user experience. And that, as you can understand, weakens instead of strengthens the brand. And that's why companies spend time looking at what is the user experience. Next slide. Team empowerment. So obviously team members in a club or in a store or even, you know, on a digital platform, team members are often the people that deliver the user experience or deliver how the customer contact. And next slide. Your best brand ambassadors at your club are obviously your club members. And that's why I encourage you to think about what does your club stand for and let your members know what your club stands for so that they can deliver that experience and that great teamwork to new members that join and to each other. I think sometimes at Toastmasters are quite aware that when there's a potential new member in the audience, I usually see quite polite attention to that new member. You just want to make sure that everyone in your club can help strengthen the brand through their understanding of the brand experience. And I'll show you what I mean. Next slide. So some questions to ask in your club are, do your club members understand what your club brand stands for? Do your club members know how to deliver your club's brand promise to new members and fellow members? And can your club members describe what the brand's unique qualities are, right? So these are just some questions that will, I think, will benefit your club if your members are on board. And these kinds of exercises and questions are really great team builders because people get to give their opinions and walk away with a much better understanding of and pride in what they're standing for with their club. And I'll leave you with this last slide. This is what Jeff Bezos said, and he's kind of successful. He says, your brand is what other people say about you when you are not in the room. And that's so important. It's what are people talking about when they talk about your club or your personal brand? What are they saying about you? What have you relayed to them that they take away, that they walk away with? And thank you for your attention.
Much, Carrie, for giving such a great presentation on branding, because this is something that here at Toastmasters we really need for our club so we can build and grow and get more members and engage the ones that we have in our club. The great thing, everyone, is that we are going to have a Q&A session. Please have your questions ready in the chat because we're gonna go on forward to the next speaker. And then once everything is over after AlyceAnn, we're gonna dive right in into your questions. So make sure you have your questions in the chat, but thank you, Carrie, for everything that you have presented today. All right. So our next speaker, I'm about to get her set up right now. It's going to be VPPR Mandy. She is someone that you probably seen in the social media realm. And she's going to give you a little bit of information about what she does in her branding for VPPR Mandy and how she came about branding herself and the importance of being a VPPR. And let me just explain to some of those who are not VPPRs. And VPPR means Vice President of Public Relations. So if you're a guest of Toastmasters, and we do use a lot of acronyms when we're talking about our role in our clubs, but that is what VPPR means.
And go so, Mandy, go Mandy, go Mandy.
Yes, I am so happy to have her here and she's really wonderful. And no other ado, I want to introduce VPPR Mandy, who is from many clubs, but her main club is ViewMasters.
ViewMasters.
And welcome, Mandy.
Yay.
This is my mother and me. Mom's a retired teacher. She eats healthy and she's a frugal person. But when the leaves start turning yellow, she just becomes a completely different person. And the leaves are yellow right now. She's turned into pumpkin spice latte by Starbucks. My mom doesn't just drink it, she loves it. Mom, a venti PSL at Starbucks packs more than 400 calories, I told her. And it costs $6. Mom, the most you've ever spent on coffee is 69 cents when McDonald's has senior coffee deal. What gives? Well, but it's only available in the fall, Mom said. I can't miss it. Plus, it's Starbucks. It must be good. Well, I am a social scientist. I study human behavior and opinions. My mother really surprised me on this one because it's just completely out of character. And that was a moment I realized just how pervasive the Starbucks brand is, that it just overpowered my 70-year-old mother. And that was, to be honest, really the extent of my understanding on branding. I must confess that when the district asked me to talk with you today about branding on social media, I actually went online and Googled branding because I'm not a PR professional. The reason I stepped up to be VPPR was because, and I'm sure many of you can relate to this, because the role needed to be filled. And I started getting on social media around the same time as the virtual Toastmasters convention. And that was August, so it's been about 3 months. And I must be doing something right because I'm here today. A recent post that I wrote for LinkedIn reached 300 views in one day. And by the end of the week, 1,000 views. Given that VPPR Mandy only has 150 connections on LinkedIn, you could call that trending. The official Toastmasters podcast tweeted only 11 times in the last 40 days. And two of that 11 tweets were to retweet my tweets. So how did I do it in such a short period of time? Well, I go to the monthly education circle. That's this one, hosted by our beloved Madame PR Manager, Valerie Smith. And I also follow my own UWIN approach that I'll share with you today. So UWIN is an approach that I developed over the years because part of my job was to win multi-million dollar proposals from the federal government. Besides very strict rules and fierce competition, I had to convince the government to invest in my team of scientists. There were no tangible goods to sell. I sold on the promise of science. And I was very successful because of UWIN. And I found that it's directly applicable as VPPR, because Toastmasters is very much about fulfilling a promise, the promise to find your voice. And I don't compose social media posts until I go through UWIN. U stands for unique. Toastmasters, like Carrie said, is where leaders are made, with good communication skills. Now, every club has the same mission. So why should people come to your club, not just any other club? And before the pandemic, many guests, they kind of just show up because the club is close to work, close to home, or that the scheduling just works out for them. Now that we are all online, those geographic or scheduling advantages are no longer unique. And that's why identifying what's unique about the club is critical. And this must be the first step. At my home club, ViewMasters, it's very easy to identify what's unique. We offer unparalleled all DTM officer service. And we have several professional speakers like our president, Shanita Akintonte, who teaches PR. And she has a great podcast on branding. She's here today. Hi, Shanita. And for my other clubs, identifying what's unique kind of took some soul searching. Toastmasters Evanston uses word of the day to highlight how expanding our vocabulary can improve communication skills. And that became their brand. This is an idiom of the day. And it's really popular with guests and members because just the thought of taking out the gauntlet and public speaking is really such a difficult but necessary challenge. So, you know, that gauntlet is, it feels like you're giving yourself permission to succeed and people want to be part of success. And if my other clubs that transition well online and with my help develop auto-switching timer cards with a stopwatch you can see down the screen right now for online meetings. And thanks to YouTube, many clubs heard about this really easy to use tool and it's been used in probably at least 100 meetings in several districts by now. Okay, so who are you trying to attract? Some of you must be thinking, well, anyone who wants to join my club. Yes, of course, everyone is welcome. But when you think about it, those that end up staying, they seem to share some similar aspects. So for example, for one of my Toastmasters, on average, is 47 years old, according to the headquarters. And for one of my clubs, the average age is 60. We spend the first 20 minutes just going around the room. Each person talks about what's on their mind. And the meeting is conducted at a slower pace. So only people who enjoy that style will stay. And I stands for intent. What's the purpose of the social media post? It seems pretty simple, but in actuality, this is a very complex step. There's so much content out there, especially on social media. I open my feed, everyone is posting, commenting, using very attractive photos, GIF, videos. So what do we pay attention to? Why should they pay attention to us? When I think of social media posts that I actually spend time looking at, they're usually what shocks me, what moves me, or what I find particularly useful to me. Everything else is kind of just noise. So your intent determines the interactions. And there is another reason why people take notice, and it's the most effective reason. And I'll talk about that last. Okay, N is news. That's the actual post, the news. And because there's so much content out there, I personally don't advocate for the approach of just putting anything and everything out there because you don't want people to tune you out. And earlier I mentioned there's one guaranteed way to get noticed. And that's when people know you and they trust you. Now for individual clubs, it's really difficult to achieve that because the VPPR term is just 1 year. And very few of us can do this PR work full time. So more the reason to think strategically and using you win. And when you do that, my experience is that you win. The district also asked me to talk about how I branded VPPR Mandy. Well, that's me. While I don't intentionally, I didn't intentionally brand like myself, I did use the UWIN approach to clarify for myself how I want to be remembered as VPPR Mandy. So for you, I'm unique because I write very well. I've published extensively and I write fast, including two books by major publishers in the last 15 months. And who am I trying to attract? Toastmasters who would like to be both online and on stage. And that's not everyone. Intent. Like I mentioned earlier, this is the most complex step, but seemingly simple. Here was my thought process. I'm a volunteer. I don't get paid for doing VPPR work. And sharing my UWIN approach today, I'm not getting paid either. So what I do and what I represent as VPPR Mandy must be something that I believe in. So what do I believe in? Let's think about that. I believe in sharing resources. I believe strongly in that. So all the tools are always free. I believe in supporting our district, District 103. And also, as a non-native speaker myself, I'm also an immigrant, woman of color. Too often, I struggle with not being heard. So I believe people deserve to feel confident and hopeful when they speak up. So my intent is to share resources to enable and to encourage. So when I've gone through that process, my end for news tend to be about human interest stories to promote public speaking as a platform to uplift and not upset. And that's my brand. Back to you, Madame PRM.
All right. Thank you, VPPR Mandy. That is wonderful.
That was awesome.
And to understand what you win, yes, we do win, especially in PR.
Woo!
You can relate that message to your audience and just keep them coming and keep them coming. That's the best thing to do. But you have put the B in branding.
Yes.
But thank you so much. Oh my God, we have so much in store for you. And our last speaker of the night is going to be AlyceAnn. She is the D103. She is the video branding person for our PR team. She's amazing. And she's going to come to you about some concepts on how to use Keynote, how to put videos together to promote your brand, especially for your club. So welcome Dr. AlyceAnn Crump.
And thank you so very much. Mandy, can you stop sharing your screen or whoever's sharing the screen?
I gotta take her spotlight off. Hold on for a moment. Okay.
Hello again, everyone. How is everyone feeling on tonight? For those of you who are still with us on the screen, how many of us have iPhone or iPad? Okay, I only see two. I think it's 28 people and I only see three people, because I still see the screen, so I can't see everybody. So I see five people up. That's all I see is five people. Okay, those of us who have iPhone or iPad, are you familiar with iMovie or Keynote?
I know what it is.
Okay.
I don't know how to use it, but I know what it is in theory.
Know what it is. So we're gonna do some stuff today. Now, I see, okay, thank you. I do see some more people now. How many of us know how to use PowerPoint? Okay, there's four people. All right. May I have an opportunity to share my screen? Please. Thank you very, very much. This is in my, hopefully this works for you. I'd like you to look at something for a moment, if I can get it to play. Come on. Need you to play for it while it's loading up. I did this particular advertisement for an open house for one of the clubs that I belong to. I belong to many. And this particular advertising we put on each one of everyone in the club was able to put it on their social media if they had social media or was able to send it to someone. And I don't know why it's not loading, so please forgive me. But I did this particular video in Keynote. Keynote is an app on the iPhone or the iMac or iPad, the Apple. And I was trying to figure out, because I normally do the videos. There you are. Can you all hear that?
Yeah, I don't hear it. You probably will have to, no. When you stop share, you will have to go under, you know, when you hit share, you want to hit that sound square in the lower left corner.
Hold on. Okay. Stop share for a moment. Okay, now, when you say, and I hit share and do what?
And then in the lower left corner, that first box, it says something about sound.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
All right, you go very well. Now let's see that. Okay. Thank you for your patience. Seconds. Anybody like that? Yes, no, maybe. Yes. I think about it.
Yes, it was good.
Okay. So that was one of the videos that do, and they all are different. We want to do. We want it to be for you, a place for you to learn, to grow. I was listening to the two young previous presenters that talks about what people are saying behind our back and what people say about us in our face and behind our back. So how do you do this? What do you want your club to be known for? Since the pandemic, I have visited at least one club every day, one new club every day across the globe. I can say that I have filled out ambassadors form about 300, because some days I visit 7 clubs in a day, because I normally binge Toastmasters like most people are binging Netflix or Hulu, because it's my pastime. And what I've learned was, the reason why I started visiting clubs is because on Facebook, there is an online Toastmasters club. And in that club, they are allowed to post advertisement about their meetings. I've seen some amazing flyers, some amazing video clips of their meeting. Why not do the same for our club? Why not do it for your club? I have every club that I belong to in Chicago, and even the club that I am a area director of, there is some type of video in the making if I have not finished it as of yet. And this was one of the videos that I made from Keynote. In Keynote, it has, basically it was just a flyer. I just put some movement in it. That's all I did. Created a flyer, and I wanted to move. I wanted it to not just sit there. I wanted the video to move. So it's my portable flyer, that's what I call it, instead of a short video. Now we're gonna talk about how to do that. Those of you who have an iPhone or iPad, I want you to find the app that says Keynote. And while you're doing that, I would like Valerie to show us the race of distinction video, if she can. Do I need to stop sharing? Okay. Thank you so much for sharing that with us. Now, we did that video also from Keynote. pretty much just did a portable flyer. Every slide is a flyer. But what we're gonna do today, before I show you how to do each one, we're gonna look at, I'm gonna share my screen again, and we're gonna look at a PowerPoint. Let's see, yeah. Okay, so this is PowerPoint. I'm gonna make a video with this too. All I did with this, and it's in PowerPoint, and most computers have PowerPoint if you have Microsoft Word or Microsoft 365, Microsoft 216, anything that with Word that has PowerPoint presentation. With this presentation, I did with our logo, making sure that we had the right colors. I did not change Toastmasters anything. So I went online to Toastmasters International and got their logo. And once I found their logo, I just placed it in the center of the, in the center of this little square, this slide. And then I wrote the name of the club, which was Cabrini Green Toastmasters Club, and what day did they meet. Then I did the next slide, the Cabrini Green Toastmasters Club, the possibilities are endless. I believe that. And then pretty much the same message for all of the clubs, because all of them want just to think about the possibilities of becoming a more effective communicator, lead meetings with authority and assurance, all of the things that Toastmasters say that we are. The only difference is I wanted to make sure that whatever club that I was creating a flyer for or creating one of these minister commercials for was something unique to them. And with the Cabrini Green, it was just a possibility. They just started their lesson. No, they're a year old now. But they started September the 1st of last year. So now they're a year old with the possibilities of becoming great communicators, the possibilities of leading their meeting. Wonderful group of people. And we wanted to make a commercial for them. And the last slide was just to create the first slide. Now I'm gonna show you how to do it. Up here, where it said record the slides, they have the files, the home, the internet, design, transition, and animation. When you get to the animation and click down, there's a recording slide. So you're gonna click that. Okay, it's changed. I think my internet just wanna act up today. All right. So now I have a position that I can record. Now, one of the things I liked about this is I can see me. Your media recording device, not that, okay. I guess I can't do it because I'm on Zoom now. But earlier today, I saw a small picture of myself. I can be in the recording. I can talk about whatever it is that's on the screen and it will be its own movie. So when you push record, it will record whatever is on the screen and it will record your voice or music or whatever it is that you want to display. And what I liked about this particular screen is because it stopped, so I can go back to the beginning. So we can push the record. Now we're gonna push record, and whoever wants to play music or they want to just talk about whatever is on the screen, it will become that video. All of the flyers that I put on the screen beforehand, before I wanted to start the recording, before I wanted to record, all of the screens are there. Now I need to move you all out the way so we can go to the next slide. There you are. So this is the first one that just has the very first thing that I put on the screen. And when we do this, we have to set up time so we know how long it will be before the next slide appears. So if you're going to be talking, just sharing with whatever it is, somebody's the spokesperson for your club, they will have to make sure that it's time, because each screen is timed individually.
Oh, when
we go to the next slide.
Ellison?
Yeah.
I'm not for sure. Now, were you supposed to be showing, were you supposed to be showing Keynote, or are you just showing the slide right now?
I'm showing the slide right now. And then I'm going to go back to Keynote. I just want to know how many people.
Okay.
So this is from the PowerPoint for those that don't have an iPhone or the iPad, anything for Keynote. So this is for everyone else that did not have those. So this is a slide that I created the first time. And now it is recording. So it's going to record everything that I said, everything that we're going to do. And then it goes to the next slide. But I'm doing this now. If I'm going to record, I have to do it individually. After I do it individually, then I can push the replay button after I finish recording whatever it is that we wanted to record. So then you will see whatever movement. And I love animation. I love being able to move words around. I love being able to share. You see how these words are moving on the screen? I had to do that before I did the recording so that when it got to this page, it would separate each word, each line, to tell what Toastmasters does in this particular club. And also, when we have music to it, however we line the music up, as you saw in the other two videos from Keynote. And we also did a movie in iMovie, which is also an app from the iPhone and the iPad. Now, the problem is that it takes a lot of time to really create these things. But once you do create it, it is phenomenal. Because now, after you take the time, and Valerie and I have gone through of putting it together and making sure the timing and the music lined up with each other, or the slide was not too fast and you couldn't read the word. So it takes some time to synchronize everything and put everything in place. Now this was done with PowerPoint. We're going to stop the video and then we're going to replay it so that you will see what it's supposed to do. Back from the beginning and say replay. Now, I don't know how well this worked because I was on Zoom. And I don't know if you can hear it now because I was on Zoom as well. So sometimes it doesn't do that. But I was doing it with you all. Now that it is playing, it has the time frame. And I don't know how many seconds it is now because I did it individually while I was talking to you all. But because now it will play all the way through. And once it plays all the way through, you can come out of it and go to file. Okay. And go to export. When you do export, that will allow you to share it whenever you want. You can create a video, a PDF, a GIF, or make it so that you can put it on a CD. Or you can create handouts. It can be a still, it could be moving, whichever one that you want to save it as. So if I save it as a video, create a video rather, and then it will go to wherever file I want it to go to and save it anywhere on my computer, on my desktop, and want to download or wherever. Now, that's cool. And I don't think it will play now because I'm on, let's see, I am on as well. So let me do this so you can see. Nope, it won't let me do that. Not while I'm on Zoom. The whole thing will play all the way through, whatever it is we put on the screen, whatever it is we get the recording, and the words, whatever those are. Now, Valerie, I'd like you to play the iMovie, and we're going to go back to talk about, we're going to have a question to answer period.
Okay.
So if we play the iMovie now, then we can go and step by step what to do on your iPhone for Keynote.
Okay. And then for the sake of time, because I know we're running out of time, I'm gonna go ahead and play the video because we about to get into the Q&A session. And if you want to, ask more, people want to ask more questions, we'll probably go overtime to like 7:20, so we can at least get everybody's questions. But let me share this quick video. Let me go out of here. Let me stop sharing. All right. We're there. So this is for the annual conference that we had did this for. And this was on iMovie. Great presentation here, and I really would want to have you come back, AlyceAnn. I know that we are running out of time, and I really want people to ask you some questions and things of that nature. I know that I do want to put in the chat our actual email for our PR team, which is d103prmail@gmail.com. And I do want you to give like some last thoughts before we go into the Q&A session as well. AlyceAnn. Okay, it seems like that her bandwidth is a little bit low. I do want to open it up to any questions that you may have for our speakers, for AlyceAnn, for Carrie Lannon, and VPPR Mandy. They brought some great information to us, especially for us vice presidents of public relations, that you can apply a lot of this to your clubs as well. So do you have any questions?
Hey, this is Maren from, I'm actually not a VPPR. This is the first time I've joined this call. But for the first two presentations, Carrie did a great job of an overview of branding and mentioning that Toastmasters International is very picky about how the branding is carried out. And so I think Mandy had some thoughts about how clubs can sub-brand and still remain within the guidance of international. And I wanted to see if anybody had more thoughts, maybe Carrie, if you had thoughts along those lines to build on what Mandy mentioned in her presentation. I know we don't have a whole lot of time, so just some top of mind thoughts.
I think, Valerie, you know, when I think about branding, I don't know all the rules, but I think you said, like, for example, you can't do a logo, right? You can't do a logo.
That's correct.
Right.
Well, if you have a conference, you can create a logo for the conference.
Right. So visual identity is kind of out, Maren. But I do think, you know, and having gone to these different clubs, and, you know, AlyceAnn was saying she's going to so many, I don't know how you do that to all the different clubs, but they all do have a personality. I've been a member of a couple clubs. And so just thinking about how people are greeted when they come into the club, what the follow-up is, what the tone is within the meeting itself, are just some things that I think can distinguish one club from another.
Carrie, do anyone have any other questions for our speakers? I know when I was on the chats, I know I didn't see too many questions. I know we have a lot of great comments that everybody thought that was very valuable. So much information, hope to share with their clubs. Great session. So this is really good information, because we really want to make sure that we're bringing value to your club, where you can take a lot of information that you learn from these education sessions to make your session a success. And I know that our time was kind of cut, and I know I really want to bring AlyceAnn back here, because I want her to give a 25-minute presentation on Keynote next month. If you are available, we're going to bring you back, because when you're talking about a video, it is very important to know how to put those videos together, and it does take time. And I've worked with AlyceAnn, and to see how she work her magic and bring it out, the creativity. And I really want you to come back next month and hear all the great tools that you can use in Keynote. And yes, I am going to bring AlyceAnn back, and she's going to be our main keynote speaker for that education session in December. Yes, but everyone here, and I just want to make sure, because I know I can talk, I want to make sure that everyone had gotten their questions answered tonight, because today is gone with nighttime, especially with the time going back. All right. Well, that ends our session. Our next education session is going to be December 2nd. I want to thank Carrie Lannon. Oh my God, it was a pleasure of having you here, hearing all your expertise, seeing your face again. You know, she was part of our South Loop Speak Freaks Club, and just to see her here on the platform and talking with us about branding, and this is her profession. It was the icing of the cake. And then VPPR Mandy explaining to us what UWIN means to you, and what VPPR Mandy means as well. And then for the AlyceAnn Crump, Dr. AlyceAnn Crump, thank you for sharing with us your videos, how to put videos together. And then I look forward to seeing you again next month, December 2nd, where we'll feature Dr. AlyceAnn and how to use Keynote, and then all some other things as well to help you as a Vice President of Public Relations. Thank you. And good night, everyone.
Bye.
Thank you. Bye. Great job, everybody. Good night.
Good night.
Have a great evening, everyone.
Good night.
Good night. Good night.